If you've always been fascinated by the subject of black holes, you're not alone. Black holes are one of the most bizarre and fascinating objects in the known universe. Even scientists struggle to describe their shape, size, and composition. The only objects in the universe that can imprison light by pure gravitational force are black holes. Scientists believe they originate when a giant star's corpse collapses in on itself, becoming so dense that it warps the fabric of space and time. And any matter that crosses their event horizons, often known as the point of no return, is helpless as it spirals into an unknown doom. Despite decades of investigation, these gigantic cosmic occurrences remain a mystery. Here are 10 crazy facts about black holes that you won't believe are true. Number 1. A black hole is not really a hole. When a star reaches the end of its life, it can collapse in on itself due to gravity and turn into a black hole. These collapsed stars are called black holes because they are so dense that nothing can escape their gravitational pull, not even light. As the matter continues to collapse onto the black hole, it forms an area known as the event horizon. Anything that crosses this event horizon is pulled in and will never come back out again. Scientists estimate there are about 100 million galaxies in our universe, and each one contains hundreds of billions of stars, which means there could be trillions of black holes waiting for unsuspecting objects to cross their event horizons. Number 2, black holes can be incredibly small. They start out as tiny blobs of matter in space, but they keep getting bigger and bigger by sucking in more and more stuff from the area around them. If a black hole is sucking up everything that's around it, there will eventually come a time when its gravity is so strong that not even light can escape from it. That makes it really hard to know for sure what's going on inside a black hole. There are some theories though. Scientists believe that at the center of a black hole, where all this energy is being concentrated, an infinitely hot point exists. The gravitational pull becomes so strong at this point that atoms themselves can't hold together anymore, and everything turns into an extremely dense soup called a quark gluon plasma. And if you were unlucky enough to fall into one of these points, well then you're pretty much toast. Number 3, there are three types of black holes. They are stellar, supermassive, and miniature. Stellar black holes are the most common type. Supermassive black holes can contain up to billions of times the mass of our sun. The smallest black hole is called a miniature black hole and was discovered in 2013 by astronomers in the center of a galaxy called Messier 82. These tiny black holes may have been created when stars collapsed, or by some other process. Masses of all three types are variable, but all black holes can be described as having an event horizon around them that defines the point at which not even light can escape from the gravity. The first person to theorize about the existence of these space objects was English mathematician John Michell in 1783. He postulated that a star could possess enough matter on its surface to create a gravitational field so powerful that no light could escape from it. This theoretical limit became known as the event horizon, which is the point where this field is strong enough for light not to escape. Number 4, a black hole can be created by a supernova. A supernova is an explosion of a star, and when this happens, the core of the star collapses in on itself and becomes incredibly dense. It continues to collapse until it reaches a singularity, which is where the mass of the star's core is concentrated into an infinitely small point. This creates an area with such strong gravitational forces that not even light can escape from it. The intense gravity causes time to slow down for anything close to the event horizon, eventually bringing everything inside inescapably towards it, until all matter is smashed together at infinite density. Number 5, black holes can spin. Black holes are able to spin. We don't know for sure why, but we do know that spinning black holes can give off electromagnetic waves and radiation. Number 6, the event horizon is the point of no return. This is the radius, or distance, at which a black hole's gravitational pull becomes so powerful that even light can't escape. For example, if you were to jump into a black hole and got stuck at the event horizon, you would eventually be pulled back in by its gravity and crushed into a singularity. Scientists estimate that the event horizon for an average-sized black hole is approximately 3 miles across. Number 7, black holes are incredibly dense. Black holes are among the oddest and most fascinating objects in the universe. They're so dense and have such a powerful gravitational pull that not even light can escape their clutches. This enormous gravity is caused by their extreme density, and it bends all light and particle routes inward, making escape from black holes impossible. When a big star dies, black holes are expected to arise. When the star's nuclear fuel runs out, its core collapses to the densest possible state of matter, 100 times denser than an atomic nucleus. Protons, neutrons, and electrons are no longer separate particles in this density. Because black holes are invisible, they are discovered when they circle a normal star. Astronomers can infer the qualities of a normal star from the properties of its dark partner, a black hole. Number 8, black holes emit radiation. His early studies of black holes as a doctoral student in the 1970s were essential. Stephen Hawking discovered that black holes release radiation as a result of random quantum events near the hole's edge. Hawking radiation is the thermal radiation believed to be released by black holes spontaneously. It results from the continuous conversion of quantum vacuum fluctuations into pairs of particles, one of which escapes to infinity while the other is trapped within the black hole horizon. Number 9, there may be a limit to how big a black hole can get. A black hole is a region of space in which gravity prevents anything, including light, from escaping. The theory that there may be a limit to how big a black hole can get was first proposed by physicist Stephen Hawking in 1975. According to the theory, this limit is about 2 times the mass of our Sun, or about 30 billion solar masses. The idea behind this theory is that the escape velocity from such a huge region would be greater than the speed of light, so nothing could escape it. In other words, if you have an object with more than 30 billion solar masses and it collapses into a black hole, then nothing will ever come out of it again. Number 10, we may never see a black hole. A black hole is a place in space where the gravity pulls everything so tightly that not even light can escape. Astronomers believe there are millions of black holes in the universe, but we may never see one because they are too small and too dark to be detected with telescopes. The theory of how black holes form was developed when scientist Albert Einstein's theory of general relativity was combined with Newton's laws of motion and universal gravitation. Einstein predicted that if enough mass gets together in one place, the gravitational pull will be so strong that nothing can escape. That includes light and other types of radiation, making it impossible to take any pictures or images from outside a black hole. Final thoughts. Black holes are one of the most fascinating and mysterious phenomena in the universe. They're so weird and full of wonder that they've been capturing our attention for over a century. Though we can never explore them, we can learn more about them through careful observation and study. We may not be able to touch black holes, but they still exist in our minds and hearts. Thanks for watching, and be sure to check out these related videos you may enjoy.